Verismo is a word which describes a body of music written at the turn of the last century, and it means truth. Composers wanted to depict real life. They wanted to show real people having real problems. I think the idea really was, what can we do to absolutely bring people to their knees in terms of completely emotional experience in the opera? Liu is, she always comes very close to stealing the show, I think, sometimes, because she's so extraordinarily sympathetic and her music is incredibly beautiful. It's tremendously challenging to prepare one of these pieces and be true to the score. On one page of music, there may be 50 markings. Every single bar will have accents and, you know, will say speed up and then slow down. It's much more of a pushing and pulling, and that's the thing, I think, also that pulls on our hearts. The heavy Puccini roles just simply are not singable for me. Butterfly, Tosca, these kinds of pieces are too heavy for my voice, so I have to do more exploration. There's an enormous body of these works which aren't known. The pieces are lost in a way. The two that really stand out for me are the one from L'Odoletta, Flamen Perdonami. There's something about that tune, about this girl who's walked all the way from the Netherlands to Paris to find this man that she loves, imagining that he's forgotten all about her and not realizing that he's miserable without her as well, and she dies outside of his window. The other one that I think is so fascinating is Zaza. It's about adultery. She sings and the little girl speaks through the whole time and says, you know, my name is Toto and my father, he's taking us to America. Do you know my father? You must know my father. And in the middle of it, she sings, Zaza is saying, you know, there are really people. There are women who actually get married and have children and are happy and don't even appreciate how lucky they are. That will never happen for me. And it's just heartbreaking. The other thing we're doing on this disc is we're having everybody sing who's in every scene, whether it's a chorus or small parts. We'll have the entire forces there, which I haven't done before. I'm used to recording arias in concert versions. So this is kind of exciting for me. You know, if I get people to explore this repertoire a little bit more, then I'm very happy.